reason, some sense prevailed, and she took that, you know, that that drive home with her male colleague. It was the same evening that, from the same junction that she had eschewed a ride, a foreign national took an auto rickshaw ride home, and she was Tanya. Femina has been this lifestyle and go-to guide for me, right from when I've been 14 or 15 years old, when my mom used to subscribe to Femina, and now I do. And so it's very apt that a magazine like this, that is not just a glamour magazine, it just covers everything, covers so many age groups. It has taken the onus of coming to our rescue with the Femina to Your Rescue app. There are lots of apps that have come out for women's safety, but I think the special features that your app has is the fact that you're armed with information. A lot of apps don't have that kind of information. The articles that you cover in your magazine will be available to you in terms of defense moves, in terms of rape laws, in terms of legalities, step by step, exactly. How to actually register an FIR. So these are, you know, armed with information, you are so much more powerful. So that is one thing that I think is very special with your app, and the fact that there's that siren. Also, the ease with which you can alert your contacts, because, you know, if you have to get into, you unlock your phone and get into the app, by the time you've gotten into the app, you wasted a lot of time. So if you just, even if you have your phone in your hand and you press the power button 3 times, without anybody around you even knowing it, I think that's of prime importance, being able to reach your emergency contacts without actually wasting a lot of time. Yeah, you're already jittery. The fact is you can press that button 3 times and get to your contacts and get to the police. So I think your app has some very special features. And I thank you and, of course, the Mumbai police for coming up with this initiative and making us feel all the more safe. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mandira. Thank you so much.
We took an effort. We took one step ahead. And 7 months back, we started adding extra layer of GPS in the vehicle, that in the case, in the situation where if a driver will always be traceable, and, you know, anybody can reach to that specific transport vehicle. We are really happy that, you know, the Femina mobile app is now in place, and we are very soon going to integrate Ola mobile application with Femina app, so that the safety that is available, the concept of
all of you, and besides saying that it's a pleasure being here, it is also an eye-opener that you, the media, the press, is taking such a responsible position about not just the app, but letting people know about how to save themselves. This app is brilliant. Brilliant why? At the touch of a button, I feel safe, I feel protected, and most of all, as a doctor, I have seen traumatized women and children in my practice, I have treated them. But come what may, they would not make a formal complaint anywhere against their perpetrator, against their abuser. This has become my pet peeve. And with this app, we are assured anonymity, which is the best part about this app. Only people concerned will know about my trouble. I don't have to go to the police station to file an FIR. They come to me. I can in some small way save face that I'm the one who has been victimized for no fault of mine. Even today, women take it as their fault, although they are not at fault, they are just the victims. And I'm happy that we have this app, and sure, it's brilliant. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Android platform. The app offers security on your fingertips and has some very handy features to ensure your safety 24/7. Thank you all. I'd like to thank all my panel members for demonstrating this commitment to the cause of women's safety in India. And finally, I...
Hello, Mrs. Singhaja. This question is from the kind of situation that they have been in, and also kind of given you ways that we can come out of it. Like when they shared the stories with you, a general perspective that you got, a few points.
You're right. I mean, most of them that have come to me have been abused at home. most of them women and children, and some on the street. It starts with eve teasing, which is just shoved under the carpet. And that is the seed which is sown for the criminalization of that person. So in my practice, and throughout my life, between Priyanka and I, we have endeavored to bring out this awareness to everyone I've been in contact with, that you start young, start from children, be it boys, be it girls, all of them are susceptible. Anybody could be a victim today, it's not just the women. Teach them a few safety precautionary guidelines. Do not talk to strangers, do not take a ride with strangers, do not accept gifts from strangers, even if they are daddy's friends. Should teach them difference between good touch and bad touch. I've been to Priyanka's school, and I was kind of a counselor in their school, my son's school, and I was given this responsibility. I used to have this talk with the children and the parents that you only can indoctrinate your children. You can't tell a guy, once he's already developed this nonsense, to change, or a girl to change. It's very difficult to start young, before their brains have been damaged by the bad internet content, by the bad abusive things. And most importantly, what I was saying is, the women should be given the power, the strength to believe that they will not be uprooted out of their own homes because they are victims. I will not put a woman into a remand house. I will not put my child into a foster home. I will get the perpetrator, the abuser out of the house. He is the one who needs treatment. He is the one who needs help. I would take the man off from his comfortable zone, be it an employer, be it a husband, be it a brother, be it a father-in-law, mother-in-law, whoever. They should be removed from their dignified, comfortable position and sent, at least get psychiatric evaluation and help. They are mentally ill. You put them with criminals, like criminals, they come out hardened, worse, and they become rapists and murderers. We should stop before it becomes, goes to this point. And it's never too late to start. We should start today, now, from our, with our children. Maybe 10 years, 15 years down the line, we would be able to make a difference. And I think every citizen is your moral responsibility, not just to look after your own house, but to look after everyone in your neighborhood. Suppose you see your neighbor, the woman in the neighboring house being victimized, she will never come forward and make a complaint against her husband because she's not sure how it will be taken with. The stigma, will she be thrown out of the house, all those things. So the police, I would request, should take cognizance of a non-family member's complaint and keep that family under observation at least. So suppose there's a repeat offense, then you should pick that person out. Not let innocent people be damaged and then it is too late. So this is what has been my job. Thank you.
That was really helpful. Thank you so much.